Hello, beautiful people, and welcome back to my channel. As you see here, I have you guys placed in front of my altar, and we're gonna be cleaning it today. I've been waiting for such a long time to introduce you guys to this part of my life. This little section in my house is very near and dear to my heart because I spend a lot of time here, you know, manifesting and attempting to get my life in order. So yeah, we're gonna be cleaning this, and if you have any questions, comments, concerns, you know, just anything about this part of my life, feel free to communicate with me, and I'll get back to each and every last one of you. So right here we have my tarot cards. These are the tarot cards that I use, just in case you guys are interested. We're gonna move these out of the way. I have my sage and my burning plate here. This is where I, of course, burn my sage, or if I'm doing certain spells or whatever and it needs to be burnt, it goes on this plate. It pretty much catches like all of my ashes and things like that, so we need to clean that off. It's got a little plastic bag here, so we're gonna throw all of this in there. Here we have my candles, and you can see like this stuff really needs to be cleaned off. So yeah, I just usually break off whatever little residue is there. Gotta get this old candle out. Okay, this is also an old candle. I don't even know why I have a top here, and I'm not gonna get this like all the way clean, but you know, just take off whatever little excess wax I do have here. Here we have like another little candle holder for my smaller candles, and all of my beautiful stones. Like I love my stones. They all have different meanings. I've had a few of these for over a year, so I don't remember what all of them mean, but yeah, I have quite a bit of those. Got my feather water that I got from Miami. Stuff like this doesn't even belong over here, it just ends up over here in time. An old camera. Lip gloss that I don't even use anymore, it's trash. A thank you letter from a company I bought some stuff from. Then in this little jar, this really is originally was supposed to be like an offering jar. We'll get into that later if y'all don't know about that, but and it just ended up turning into like a spot where I just store shit, basically, like CBD, the wraps, and business cards. Crushed red peppers from Little Caesars. And matches. I didn't even know I had matches. Probably stole these from D. Because I don't even use matches. Now we have a empty platform. We're gonna get rid of this and put down a new one. If you've been thinking about making you an altar and don't know where to start, get 2 milk crates. That's what I use. I'm going to place a fresh white cloth down. And white is the only background that I use for my altars. I don't use any other colors because white is neutral. There's like other reasons behind it, but once again, we'll get into that in a later video if you guys are interested. We can start setting everything back up. I'm gonna start with our sage plate, our big plate, with our stones. Let me place all our stones on here. And honestly, y'all, I really need to cleanse my stones. So I guess I'll do that in another video. If you have stones and you're not sure how to cleanse them or where to get them, or if you have any questions about stones, again, put it in the comment box and I will reply to you guys. And if it's plenty of questions and comments, I'll do like a whole nother video. I need new candles. I only have one left. That's a problem. So that will definitely be going on my agenda very soon. I'm gonna put this back up here. We have to put our feather back up here. And yeah, okay, so backstory about this feather. I like to tell myself that I manifested this feather. Well, I know for a fact that I manifested this feather. I knew that I needed a feather for my altar. This was last year. And so I just kept, you know, thinking about a feather. I was like, I need a feather, I need a feather, I need a feather. And I just kept, you know, speaking this out loud or whatever. I was like, I'm gonna find a feather one day. And I was at work, back when I was working at the daycare, and it was when I had my after school kids. And they brought me this feather. It's like, Miss Tisa, we found this big old feather. And I was just, I love this because it's symbolic to me because I actually manifested it. I didn't go buy it. And, you know, it came from my after school kids at my old job. And I love those kids. So it just is really sentimental to me. So, yeah. I actually need to put this water in a mason jar. It is not supposed to be in plastic. It really does no good in plastic whatsoever. And I know this, but I've just been holding on to this little bottle since October. So, yeah, I haven't done any rituals or spells or anything with it. It just needs to come out of this. D said he put my mason jar somewhere. I still have not found my mason jar that D claims is in the cabinet. He's been saying that for so long. I have no idea where it is. I have to go to the store and get another mason jar so that I can put this in there, because like I said, it honestly, like, yeah, I have it on my altar, therefore I have earth, wind, water, blah 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 blah, but it really holds no, I'm not gonna say it doesn't hold value because the water itself has value, but it really don't hold no weight by being in this. It needs to be in glass. And all of your things, if you are interested in doing stuff like this, everything needs to be glass. But I got my water. My tarot cards usually are over here in this little corner, which I really need to start using more of and getting more connected to my tarot cards. I'm pretty connected though, I will say that. Like, yeah, we got a, me and my little tarot cards, we got a vibe. Mystic is her name. Me and Mystic has a pretty good, we have a good vibe. We have a good aura together, and she's pretty accurate with me, so. okay, and forget about this. A little candle holder. This candle holder right here is used for, like, I use this one, like, if I'm doing certain spells and I need, like, a smaller candle, that's what I use this for. I guess we could put these matches back over here in case we get ready to do some shit and then we can't find a lighter. Okay. Now our altar is clean. This looks a hell of a lot better than what it did when I originally showed it to you guys.
So yes, this is what my altar looks like when it is clean and pretty. And I, you know, my background is just really my 2020 vision board, because this is where I come and, you know, manifest things and get all my thoughts together. I will see you guys in another video. If you're interested in these kind of videos, thumbs up. Put your comments and stuff in the comment section so that we can do a little series of stuff like this. Bye.